run with focus. Focus is the key to running victoriously. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. In the race of life, what are the distractions that could cause us to take detours, that could slow us down? We have a passage in Luke chapter 8, verse 14 tells us, now the ones that fell among the thorns are those who, when they had heard, go out and are choked with cares, riches, pleasures of life, and bring no fruit to maturity. It's possible to have the word of God in our hearts and yet not bear fruit. And scriptures highlight the fact that, you know, many of us, we could simply be overcome by the cares of this world. As we follow God, there are responsibilities that each one of us needs to focus on. But to worry about these responsibilities and to be preoccupied about these responsibilities and not give God the first place would distract us from following God fully, from focusing on God fully. The other thing that we see as a distraction is the riches of this world. So while it's important to experience the success that life has to give and the abundance, Jesus has died so we could have his abundance. But at the same time, you know, if we have given riches the first place in our lives, it's possible for us to be distracted from the call of God for us. So we need to keep the focus, give God the first place always, you know, then everything else has to follow that. The third issue of life that could distract us, as we just read in Luke 8, is the pleasures of life. Now, as God's people, while enjoying the good of the land, while enjoying the blessings of the world, if we give the pleasures of this life first place, a place above God, once again, it's a burden, it's a weight on us, and we're not able to run the race that God has called us to run with great focus. So today, I'd like to encourage us to check our hearts, to allow God's Spirit to work in us, and to identify anything in our lives that could be slowing us down. We have been called to run the race, but run the race with focus. Let's pray together. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you that you have made us overcomers. You have given us, Lord, dominion over sin, sickness, and death. Lord, if today, Lord, sin be weighing people down, Father, we ask, O God, that by the power of your Spirit, that, Lord, you would reveal, Lord Jesus, you would convict people's hearts, O God. Lord, any distraction that could be taking them away from your plan and purpose for their lives, God, that they will find the strength of the Spirit, O God, Lord, to yield back to your word, God, to realign themselves, oh God, to your plans and purposes. God, we ask that every distraction be removed in the name of Jesus, God. Every bondage be broken in the name of Jesus, God. That each one of us, Lord, will run this race clear with a clear focus, God, with our eyes on the end goal, Father. Father, we thank you. We thank you that Lord, it's only you who can give us that kind of strength. And Father, we bless you and honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.